Man, some team is going to get CeeDee Lamb, and that team may not be my team, and I'm going to be pissed. CeeDee Lamb, number two, wide receiver, Oklahoma. Let's talk about him. You know, I feel like every year there's a new player that kind of moves the culture along in terms of player evaluation or whatnot, right? Think about, it's two guys from last year, actually. Think about DK Metcalf. He was drafted in the third round because he can't turn. And I think that's appropriate because if you want to be a first-round receiver, you got to be able to turn. But what he was really good at, like he ran slants really, really well and hitches and screens and nine routes, right? Cool. So when he got to Seattle, all he ran was slants and hitches and screens and nine routes. And he was really, really good, right? Think about Deebo Samuel for San Francisco, who's not a polished receiver at all. Like, he's not a great route runner or receiver, but what Deebo was really good at was getting the ball in his hands and being really hard to tackle. So what we saw from Deebo Samuel in the Super Bowl is him getting the ball quickly and being hard to tackle, right? I think there's going to be a new trend for quick game receivers in the National Football League, right? And I think this year, CeeDee Lamb is probably going to be the guy that leads that new revolution in respecting, I may not be polished receiver yet guy, but I'm damn good yet guy. Okay. So CeeDee Lamb, who I think is a pretty good receiver. Is he the most polished in his class? Probably not. But year one, you can definitely use him as quick game yet guy and then let him develop into the receiver you want him to be. He ain't got to have the biggest route tree right now. He ain't got to be the most nuanced right now. But does he have a place in your offense? Absolutely. Let's take a look at this one play from CeeDee Lamb right here, right? CeeDee Lamb's going to come across the left side of the screen. Boom. Boom. He's going to make guys miss. And I think CeeDee Lamb making guys miss is really interesting because he's not making guys miss with super physical traits. It's more so his contact balance and him reading defenders before they get there. Let's just run it back one more time. Of course, he has some speed that he's going to beat this guy with, right? He's going to basically read the angle that this defender is taking. Then right when he gets there, he's just going to sidestep him. You see that? All right. That wasn't some big shady McCoy in his prime level quickness. It was just, I see where you at and I'm just going to simple sidestep you, right? You're going to miss because you're not fast enough. Get off the ground. You're messing up your clothes, my guy. You're not fast enough. And then these other guys are just going to simply try to arm tackle him. And he's just going to do that and contact his balance all the way. Contact balance his way all the way to the end zone, which I think is interesting, right? Because a lot of people are going to say, and some people may in this chat box as well, they're going to say, well, Voch, what about the Big 12 defense thing? Like, he's just beating up on Big 12 defenses. I feel you on that, and you have a claim, kind of, sort of. But at the end of the year, we saw him versus LSU. He had like 130-some yards against them. We saw he had a pretty good game versus Baylor in Texas, who are ranked teams. So that has to count for something. But it's a couple ways I look at it. It's not like these Big 12 people can't tackle him because he's using talent to make them miss tackles. He's using his eyes. He's using balance and anticipation. And then he has speed on the back end, right? And that's probably like 4.49 speed, maybe. I don't know. And 4.49 speed is 4.49 speed everywhere you go. Plus, if I can pause my film for a second, like, y'all want to talk about, can this translate to the National Football League? Let's be fair. There are corners in the National Football League that arm tackle as well, right? So let's just not overthink this a bit much, right? So like I said, when CeeDee Lamb gets to the league, he's going to be doing a lot of this, a lot of quick game stuff. And once he gets the ball in his hands, he turns into a runner again. Now, later on in this film session, we're going to talk about him as an actual receiver. And we ain't going to talk about it long because it really ain't much to say. But like I said, let's not overthink receivers anymore. You know what I mean? Hove did that, so hopefully we ain't got to go through that, right? You're going to get the ball out quickly to CeeDee Lamb here. Ba, 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 boom, boom, boom. Next thing you know, I'm going to contact balance my way. Look at this spin move. This spin move wasn't... It wasn't the best spin move you ever seen in your life, but he just kind of knew when to spin, right? He just knew when to spin, right? And look at this. And these guys coming in late. Oh, you activated my trap card. You activated my trap. Boy, get your Baylor ass off of me. And he goes to the end zone. And he does this a lot. He does this against damn near everybody. If he only did this against the worst Big 12 tackling team in the country, then maybe I'll understand. Okay, he did, you know, Kansas State pretty bad. But he did this against everybody for 2 years. Consistently. I don't know, my guy. I'm just not ready to just use Big 12. I'm not ready to use Big 12 as an example against CeeDee Lamb just yet, man. I don't think I'm ready to do that just yet, my guy. Take a look at this play. Let's see what's going to happen here. Oh, this is just movement. This contact balance and movement. Just moving, 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 moving. Get you up off me. And finally, this guy grabbed the right ankle and just got me up out of there. I don't know, man. CeeDee Lamb is a fun player to watch, man. He's definitely a day one starter. That's something else you got to think about when you're drafting guys, right? Can they help you? Look at this. Can they help you day one? CeeDee Lamb also running through people there. CeeDee Lamb absolutely got some day one worth to him. He's absolutely got some day one worth to him. And plus, when he develops, he'll probably be an even better receiver after that, right? I want everybody to go in their backyard and try to do this, man. Like go find about three friends and go in your backyard. I want you to contact balance your way through a tackle and then leap over an arm tackle and try not to fall into the grass. All this full speed. And don't pull no muscle and and don't end up, you know what I'm saying, like in your neighbor's backyard or whatever. This ain't easy to do. This ain't easy to do. If it was easy to do, every receiver would be that guy. And most receivers can do yak things, but they do yak things in different ways. We talked about Henry Ruggs. He did yak things by being faster than people, you know. Jerry Jeudy, may do yak things being quicker and smoother than people. Well, CeeDee Lamb is going to anticipate your tackles. He's going to read your angles. He's going to contact balance. Let's take a look at some plays, just him being a pure receiver here, right? And to be fair, we ain't got to just look all over the place to go find him, because – regardless of what he's doing at receiver, regardless of the route that he's running, after he catches the ball, he's going to turn right back into yak guy again. So it really doesn't matter if he's the receiver that you want him to be or not. You can win with him. You can win with him. If Deebo Samuel had a couple more carries or a couple more quick catches, there's no telling what could have happened, but they stopped going to him, so. Hey, man, if CeeDee Lamb on my team, I'm not going to stop going to him. Let's see what happens here. This the big joint down the field. Over three defenders. Yup. He just going to get away from all those guys. There's another one, too, that he jumped over like three people. You know what I mean? And to be fair, we don't have as many examples of him jumping over people as we have of him, you know, taking short passes and just not getting tackled. Take a look at that. I would like to see a lot more CeeDee Lamb just jumping over people. And hey, like I said, combine's coming up, so we get to see what his hands are like downfield. We get to see the kind of routes he can run. Now, you know, I don't incorporate too much combine thinking into my thoughts or whatever. But hey, man, what you want me to say? What you want me to say? Get your Texas ass off me, boy. Oh man, I wanted to do it on my team, man. I want him on my team, and my team don't even need receivers. Cowboys don't need receivers, but how would I use CeeDee Lamb day one? I think he could play inside and outside for you. What made me say inside is, sure, let him be a jet sweep guy, let him run those quick patterns in the, you know, just those slants and hitches and screens, let him run them from the slot. If you want him to go play outside, I'm talking Cowboys now. You want to play outside, put your best receiver at slot, then you can just do what you want to do, put him out. Man, it's endless opportunities. It's endless opportunities. Plus, at the end of the day, in about 3 years, he'll be a number one wide receiver for you. So, fantasy football nerds, go get you one, especially depending on what team he goes to. I'm a big fan of CeeDee Lamb. All right, so we dropped Henry Ruggs yesterday, and I know we got the CeeDee Lamb joint now. We'll probably drop Jerry Jeudy tomorrow, but hey, as of now, who I like the most, I don't know. We'll see by the end of the week, and I'll definitely have a better answer by April. But until then, I appreciate y'all for tuning in, bro. I'm gonna be pissed if he go to the Eagles. The YouTube Illuminati is taking money away from your favorite content creators, and people often ask the best way to support the channel directly. I tell them that subscribing to my Patreon. Just $1 a month would increase production and the frequency of uploads. Basically, that means more content for you. For less than a bag of almond M&Ms, you can support the channel, call dibs on requests for future videos, and you can have access to Patreon exclusive material like my throwback film sessions. That's patreon.com/VochLombardi. I appreciate the support. Doski Woski. Salute.